Konbanwa.
Konbanwa.
Welcome to Terrace House English Couch Podcast. This is a podcast where we don't just recap the show, we do commentary over the episode, like the Japanese director's commentary, but in English.
Yeah, we have like a countdown about 10 minutes in. So if you want to watch with us, you can do that.
Yeah, watch along. It's a lot easier to figure out what we're actually talking about.
I'm a Dr. Dazza.
And I'm Kirra.
And I think we should just like jump straight into the episode.
Yeah, let's get started. Do you really believe that you can never be sure? They're leaving
bodies in stairwells or washing up on the shore. As usual, we should apologize for the air conditioning sound that you might be hearing in the background, all the cicadas. It's a Japanese summer. I don't need to explain it anymore.
I was like, I think most people, especially the people in Tokyo, would very much understand the deathly loud noise of cicadas and, you know, the overuse of air conditioners.
Yes. So, what happened last week?
Well, we got the conclusion of the girl fight.
Girl fight, yeah.
Yep. Which very much seemed like Risako either didn't want to deal with Haruka whatsoever.
Or there was a producer in the background pushing her to apologize.
Yeah, and then there's Shohei sitting in the background just amused and...
He was getting a drink of water very slowly and sniggering the entire time.
Wasn't it cereal? I think he was just sitting there eating cereal, which makes it so much better.
Oh, it was just like him being like, I'm totally not listening.
Haha, cereal.
And then there was the date between Kaori and Ruka.
Yeah, what was it? Tamago kake...
Gohan.
Kake gohan.
Yeah,
kake. I was going to say kake gori, but kake gori
is completely different. Or just tamago gohan.
Yeah.
Which is a breakfast food.
Is it tamago gohan or tamagohan?
Tamagohan.
Tamagohan.
No, well, it's actually tamago gohan.
I like it better if it's tamagohan.
Yeah. But that's a traditional Japanese breakfast food. It's just raw egg, soy sauce, and rice.
It's super simple when you don't feel like cooking.
And I don't know why they went to an expensive restaurant to get it.
Because it's supposed to be like... special. You, even if it's something simple you can make at home with little ingredients, if you go to an expensive restaurant, it shows how much you care about that person to give them simple food but really expensive.
Well, it would if she didn't pay for it all.
Yeah, that was a little bit of a mess up on his point.
Yeah, she kind of treats him like a child.
She does.
Which is both adorable, but really sad for him.
But the thing is, like, we've seen interaction between her and Kenny. Yeah. And she acts pretty much the same towards Kenny, except with Kenny, she's just like, oh, you know, I'll pay for this, this is cool. And then he'll fight back. And yeah, it's kind of a banter. But with Ruka, he's like, I've got this. And Ruka's like, what, huh?
Yeah, there was no banter there. They weren't equals.
Yeah.
And that's probably his biggest problem going forward, if he wants to get Kaori at all.
Yeah, he has to be seen, like, more mature.
He has to be seen as a man instead of a boy, which is fine. I think he can do that. He's the one that's probably maturing the most in the house, which is really good.
Yeah.
Unlike the two girls who are regressing into childs.
Speaking of being seen as a man, there was also the...
Shohei incident. The pink film. Oh, God. Now, we actually got a comment on Twitter about this. We suspected pink film was kind of like an American term for just softcore.
Yeah.
Because we've heard the term before, but not in any real context. And the context that they had in the Japanese was a softcore film.
Yeah.
And you spoke to your Japanese friends about it.
Yeah.
And they didn't say anything off colour.
They were actually really kind of happy about it. They were like, oh, that's really good. He'll get more views as being seen as, you know, the cool man kind of thing.
But then we found out pink film actually means softcore gay film.
Yeah.
In American culture. And so I'm confused to know whether they did actually mean he's going to be starring in a softcore gay film, or it's just going to be a softcore porn.
There wasn't really enough context there, and I know Japanese is built upon just figuring out the context.
Yeah, but even in the, like, scenario, we couldn't figure out the context.
Yeah.
And no
Japanese person we've spoken to has said anything about gay.
Has enlightened us on what kind of softcore this is.
So, I'm confused.
Me too.
And I find it would be really interesting either way.
Yeah.
Especially if he gets Haruka to run lines with him. She can be top, he can be bottom.
Yeah, I think that would do wonders for their relationship.
I think it'll do wonders for their images.
For their acting, maybe. It's easier to act if it's all reality.
But yeah, so that was a thing.
Mm. A lot happened last episode.
Yeah, it was. I didn't mind last episode as much. I didn't like it as much as the week before.
Mm.
But I think that's mainly because this week everyone was kind of like avoiding the situation.
Yeah.
Because all the rest of the housemates were like, you girls can figure this out. We're gonna have fun over here.
Also, everyone had a lot to do as well. Kenny had his, Aloha concert.
Oh, yeah, with Yusuke?
Yeah.
With Yusuke?
Kaori had, she's building up to when her exhibition was, so she's dealing with that, plus the t-shirt designs.
Mm.
Ruka was putting all his effort into this one date.
And failing spectacularly on it.
Yeah.
They got some art supplies.
They did, but the date wasn't about the art supplies.
No.
And I think that's all that happened is they bought art supplies.
And then went for breakfast at dinner time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which, Brynna is great, by the way. There is nothing wrong with Brynna.
Breakfast is just breakfast at all times.
There exactly.
There's no such thing.
There is a reason why McDonald's serves breakfast all day.
Do they?
Not here, they don't, unfortunately.
I think in Australia they did.
In Australia they do, yeah. But here they don't because...
Because that's smart and what normal people do.
Limited time menus are very common here.
Yeah.
God, it's so annoying sometimes. Like, sometimes you're just like, oh, I want to get this. And they're like, oh, sorry, it's like a minute after this time.
Yeah, like, oh, the time's up.
And we're just like, no, but I want this, like, ice cream. And they just can't, they just don't give it to you.
Mm.
It's so annoying. And then, like, the drinks, they just disappear.
Oh, the summertime drinks. It's so sad.
They don't bring back, like, last year, they had, like, a Jim and Coke.
Yeah.
Like, in a can. You can't get that here normally. They call it a cola highball. And it was so tasty. It tasted exactly like it did back home.
Yeah.
Basically. And we're just like, this is the best. We're going to drink a lot of these.
We bought a lot of stores out of their supply.
We actually did. Like, every time we found, like, a new store that had it, we're just like, well, let's buy, like, six of them.
Yeah, let's just buy a lot.
Because they didn't have six packs of them.
No.
But do you think they brought them back this year?
No.
No, they didn't. No, they have this, like, other, like, chew high drink, which is actually quite tasty.
What's the yellow shot?
Yeah, the yellow shot, yeah.
Yellow shot's a different company, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the Sapporo one.
Okay.
It's a Sapporo. It's like lemon squash instead of like normal lemons.
Yeah.
And it's real good.
It's pretty good.
But it's going to disappear in like 2 weeks and never be seen again.
Yeah.
I'm just like, come on, guys. Oh.
Anyway, let's continue with the synopsis of this coming episode. Terrace House Part 1, Episode 11. Broccoli pasta carbonara style. Kaori admits that she's losing confidence in her artistic abilities, but Kenji isn't very supportive. Ruka talks about his dreams, but he lacks focus.
That's how I make carbonara with broccoli.
What?
Like broccoli pasta, carbonara style. It tastes great.
It actually is kind
of amazing. And it's super easy to make.
I love how that's what you're hanging on. You're hanging on the title that has to do with food.
I'm hungry, okay? We haven't eaten our breakfast yet.
It's okay. We'll have to wait till dinner time for breakfast.
Oh, no. So we eat dinner now?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll go make some carbonara.
Actually, I was thinking about gyoza.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't surprise me that Kenny isn't very supportive in anything. He seems very much like, oh, you're having a problem. Oh, that seems like a you problem.
This sounds like a very, very interesting episode to me. Mostly because it deals with Kaori and, her arts style and stuff like that. Maybe we'll get to see, Kenny being less of a perfect guy. And Ruka might actually focus on something.
Maybe. I'm kind of hoping that we don't focus on Haruka and Risako this episode. Just because we've had so much with them.
Yeah.
That I'd like to see more of everyone else's interactions. Especially like Shohei. Like, especially the boys interacting with each other. That's something we've completely lacked this season.
It's just some
bro moments.
Bromances.
Yeah. And I really want to see that. Even if like like, one of the girls is part of that bromance, it's fine. Like how Miwako was that in the original series.
Yeah.
That's cool. I just want to see that rather than the whole, let's try dating or...
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, want to count us down?
Okay. 3, 2, 1, go.
Netflix logo. So I turn it down so it doesn't get picked up by Mike. Konbanwa. Oh, look at his hair!
His hair!
Oh my god!
He has platinum blonde hair.
Oh, this is a new filming session. Obviously.
Well, yeah, you get that with the platinum blonde hair.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, there was all the rooftop stuff as well. Like, the rooftop date.
Yeah, that, like, that Kenny did nothing in. Remember? They went to, what was it? Zara Home in Omoto Sando. Oh, his hair.
It's actually, what do you think? I think it's actually kind of cute.
It makes him look very Gyaru.
Gyaru is okay.
Yeah, I mean, that's fine. It's just a big change.
I think maybe he should have gotten his entire hair done instead of leaving the roots dark.
But that's the style, though.
But
it was cute.
Mm.
Art tools. I know, he kind of looks like he's actually part of like a South Korean band.
He does, yeah. He looks like a K-pop idol.
Oh yeah. He's a child. I mean, I like Spider-Man.
Yeah, but like,
I wouldn't say that he's who I want to be.
Mm.
When Kaori drinks, she just smiles the entire time, and her face, like, her cheeks are super red. It's really cute. Kenny's the worst. Like, really?
He doesn't give any answers or, like, push forward with anything.
No, he's just kind of, like, existing in this universe.
He has such a good image.
That he just tries to keep.
Mm.
But
he won't do anything to taint his image at all.
Which I think is tainting his image.
Very much so, yeah. Seriously, no one's referencing his hair?
Come on, Yamasato. Do it. God.
No one's referencing his hair.
Yeah. That's the problem. He thinks he's looking cool and aloof, but it's just pissing everyone off.
Yeah.
Like, it's pissing me off, it's pissing you off, it's pissing the panel off, it's pissing Risako off. Hmm. Be my boyfriend, basically.
Mm.
I guess the last one is Shohei. Maybe she's gonna go for Kaori next, who knows?
Shohei will do his pink film and then everyone will be like, he's so dreamy.
That's understandable.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when you're dating someone, it's a... When you're in a friendship, even, it's a two-way street.
Yeah.
If they don't initiate something after you initiating everything, what's the point?
Yeah, you don't feel like hanging out with them anymore because it doesn't feel like they have any drive to...
to expand the friendship or the relationship.
What video games?
Rehydrate news.
Huh.
I never thought of doing it that way.
Yeah.
Huh.
This is making me so hungry, though. What kind of food is, like, a perfect Terrace House snack?
A Terrace House snack?
Yeah, if you're sitting here having, like, a, for example, a viewing party, where you're watching 4 or 5 episodes at once with a bunch of friends, what kind of snack would you want to bring to that party?
I think it's more izakaya-style food.
For example?
For example, like karage, yakitori, that kind of stuff.
I guess so.
I know, it just seems like that kind of food. Like a movie, like a Marvel movie or something. It's like popcorn or something like that.
But the Terrace House is more casual izakaya style.
Yeah, and you have like a few drinks at the same time. That's what I imagine, at least. They must have all gone to see Endgame.
Yeah.
Or something.
I think you should try being a stuntman.
Nah, Toku actor.
Toku actor would be pretty good.
Yeah.
He could be full of Kamen Rider.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it's kind of unrealistic.
Not with the amount of films they put out.
No, but... they need someone that can speak English.
Yeah, for example.
Yeah. It's really difficult. I don't know, it's just, it's one of those things, I guess.
Come learn English. Let me teach you English.
just slide into his DMs. Hey, you want some English lessons?
Hey, I'll give you English lessons. Don't worry, we can use Marvel vocabulary.
This is Infinity Gauntlet. Please read.
We just spend the entire time sitting there reading comic books.
See, it's some, it, like, there are some Japanese actors who have broken out in America. Like, Ken Watanabe. There was, I can't remember his name, but he's the guy that was in Endgame. The one that...
Where people were really angry because they brought him on just to kill him.
Yeah. You know, and then they're making, like, what is it, Shang-Chi as well, which is an all-Asian cast.
Oh, yeah.
But it's all Chinese-Asian cast.
Sadly.
So.
I would love to see more toku actors break into, like, Western superhero.
Yeah.
I think that would be fantastic.
It would make sense.
Can you imagine, like, previous Ultramen coming on to play some characters?
In, like, Marvel.
Oh, that would be so good. No.
Do it.
No. You should never just go to something just to watch. Always try it out.
It's like we were playing D&D the other day, and one of the people that we played with, one of his friends, was interested in D&D and wanted to come and watch. And I'm like, no. If he's coming, he's playing.
Yeah, it was like, okay, when my sister started doing wrestling, she was like, oh, you should come to tryouts. I'm like, nah, I'll just come and I'll watch and I'll sit down and I'll be fine. And she's like, okay, you do that. And she told all of the trainers that I'm coming to try out. So they dragged me into the ring.
Yeah.
Of course he's hungover.
I know that feeling all too well. Was it OP pitches?
The first word was virgin. That's all I read. I couldn't see the kanji quick enough.
OP virgin. Exactly. Yeah, well,
not sure.
But if she's giving off enough hints.
And the thing is, he's not making the first move. She's made a lot of moves.
Yeah.
He's just making a big move.
Yeah. I mean, there's three ways that a kiss could go.
Mm.
Right. And two of them is making you feel bad. The third one makes you feel good.
Yeah.
Right. There's trying and it not working, so you feel a bit, like, embarrassed or awkward. Right. But that will pass. There's not doing it and regretting not even trying, which makes you stew on it for God knows how long.
Yeah.
And there's doing it, kissing, and you feel elation.
Or there's the other one where you don't feel anything, which is kind of the worst outcome.
Really? I find that to be, like, at least better than not doing it or...
Oh, yeah. I'm talking about, like, if you've got two people and they both like each other, and then you kiss, and one falls more in love, one falls less in love.
Oh, that's awkward.
That is, like, the worst possible situation.
Yeah. Oh, God damn it. I'll have to edit that. I sneezed, I apologize. Ooh, green curry. Oh, that does look good. Looks very fancy.
I think I've realized Ruka kind of reminds me of my brother.
Your little brother?
Yeah. I think that's why, like, I don't find him attractive at all, is because all his actions, for example, like hoarding glasses.
Wanting to be Spider-Man.
Yeah, wanting to be Spider-Man, like, not being focused or settled on anything. He reminds me of my little brother. Or not handling alcohol.
What's wrong with that? He just works a lot.
And there she reminds me of my little sister.
Mm. See, she's got that, like, smile.
Yeah.
Thank you.
she needs a passion project.
She's got a passion project.
Does she?
Yeah, it's her entire life.
Exactly. If your entire life's a passion project, it's not a passion project.
It's true. That's good. I mean, Lauren never went to art school.
No.
So. She's gonna ruin it. Maybe, I don't think the professor said the right thing.
I think the professor might have been a little bit annoyed on how many opportunities she got so quickly.
I mean, it's obvious that she got more popular because of Terrace House.
And not just that, though. It's like...
But she's been lucky in the fact that she'd been able to use, like, Instagram and...
Yeah.
All this other stuff to help propel herself.
Mm-hmm.
Right, and being an artist, a freelancer, basically any business, is like 50% talent, 50% marketing.
Mm.
Always. You have to be able to do that. You know, and part of that marketing is drive. And some people will think you're arrogant. You know, you think you're better than you are. Mm. There are times when I'm doing my writing and I feel like I shouldn't be able to do this, like, there are people so much better than me, but,
yeah,
you know.
It's like, but it really is hard to build up your art style.
Yeah.
Because you have to sell yourself to be confident in your abilities. It's like, oh, you should pick me because my art style really, you know,
works for
fits your product. Yeah. That's really good. But then secretly, you know, okay, they're, like, looking at all these people are way better, and I have to try and steer...
Mm.
The person I'm being interviewed by, steer them away from artwork that's better for them, just so I get the job.
Who they think, like who you think is better for them.
Yeah.
Rather than your work.
It's like, and it really is, you said it's like 50% marketing, but sometimes people aren't cut out for that marketing.
And no, they're not.
It gives you immense imposter syndrome.
I mean, it's not even like, even the people I've met, right? Including myself, you know, it's not just it's not easy to market yourself.
Mm.
And it does suck, and it's hard.
Yeah.
What? His take was awful, yeah. You know, even the best marketers I've met have periods of, I can't do this.
Mm. I think there's a lot of artists I've met can't market themselves.
Yeah, there are like so many artists and cosplayers and stuff on Twitter that I've met that are so amazing at what they do.
Yeah.
But no one can see them because they're not doing the right stuff.
Yeah.
You know, it's like if they tweak a few hashtags here and there, or, you know, if they're a bit more outgoing or something like that, they would be really popular.
Mm.
It's difficult. It's difficult for anyone.
Yeah.
And I can understand what Kaori's going through.
Yeah. I think maybe she should look for, like, a mentor. Maybe not, like, an in-person mentor, but a style she likes that she wants to kind of study.
Yeah, no, that's always the thing. Like, when I'm doing my photography stuff, yeah. I always look at someone else on Instagram who I really admire. I'm like, mm-hmm. I want to do something like this.
Yeah.
Of course, I try not to emulate that person.
Mm.
But it helps having that frame of reference to be like, I want to try this, and then twisting it your own way.
It's really hard being like, oh, I want to try this style, but I don't know how to do it.
Mm.
I can't copy them. But taking some hints from there is good.
Yeah.
Also, we're missing an amazing conversation here. You were saying before, do you think Marvel is too high a bar to hit for?
Yes.
Why so?
Because he wants to be a hero. Like Spider-Man. Right? But the problem is, Marvel is very American.
Yeah.
And as good as Feige is about diversity and stuff, that diversity is still American diversity.
Yeah.
It's Chinese American or African American.
Mm.
It's not international diversity. The only reason that they're... Oh, Okonomiyaki. The only reason that they're moving to a more Chinese American audience is because China made $700 million in Endgame.
Mm.
It's a big market.
There's a possibility, though, something he could try to do is he could try doing the voiceovers for Marvel. For example, the Japanese voiceovers.
Yeah. That's totally within reach.
But that's not what he wants to do. He wants to be on screen.
Yeah. I don't think that's... Unless he can speak perfect English... I don't think that's a possibility for him. Not in the way that he wants. Unless there's like some sort of like TV ensemble cast he's able to get into.
Yeah.
But even then, I don't know. I know that sounds really harsh, but...
Mm. Oh. Sohei is being such a good guy at the moment.
Yeah.
He's like told Kenny needs to step up. Mm. He's telling Kaori that Ruka...
Yeah.
Wants, like...
Something more.
Oh.
That's... Mm. I mean, I say that, but, you know, Lauren is now in Marvel shows.
Is she?
Yeah, she's in is it Gifted? Or Legion, she's in Legion.
Oh, yeah.
That Fox one.
Mm, yeah.
But she also can speak perfect English, so.
Yeah.
He should be a Tokyo actor. I'm pretty sure
I was going to say, Kaori was very straightforward in saying that she just doesn't like him to Shohei.
I'm liking this Kaori.
I actually think she's been drunk a lot.
Yeah.
Is why she's becoming so straightforward with her answers this episode.
No, you can tell she's drunk because of her face.
Yeah.
Also, a lot of scenes are at night, so... I don't trust professors a lot of the time. I mean, it's going to sound really bad. There are some really good professors out there. Like, my sound professor, when I did audio stuff, was so cool. And, like, the nicest person and be able to help.
Mm.
But my film professor was the worst.
Yeah. See, I had the opposite. I had my film professor was fantastic. My English professor was awful.
Mm. And now you teach English, so...
Mm.
Mm. Yeah. Mm.
Yeah.
Mm.
I think you're more likely to grow as an artist if you do things that are genuinely interesting for you.
Of course.
If you do things that your fans like, you're only going to stick to the same type of things. But you might get really good at that type of thing.
Hmm.
But you won't grow your own art style.
Yeah. It's...
What's it?
I think a mix of both is best.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, they're actually... Oh.
I'm really not sure how to deal with this. Oh, boobs.
Okay. This is different for Terrace House.
Yeah.
We've seen Gravia before, but...
We've never actually seen full nudity.
We know it's not gay.
Yeah.
That was a ball.
huh.
He can't kiss very well.
No, he's supposed to be drunk.
Oh, okay.
He's actually really good at playing drunk. Why is Terrace House just...
This is a thing.
I don't know if they're showing way too much of this.
I mean, okay, I get, like, the whole Japanese sensibility that sex isn't as bad as, like, America or
anything. Bring the mat.
You know what I mean? But...
Mm.
I still feel that was a bit too much, especially for Terrace House.
Without notification, that was too much.
Yeah, because that bumps, like, this show from, like, for American terms, like a PG-13 to an R.
That would be R rating.
Yeah, that...
And there was no notification, for example. Like, I don't mean to sound completely...
Puritan.
Yeah, but there was no notification for nudity. So, for example, if I was watching this with,
your younger brother and sister.
My younger brother and sister, I would have been like, I'm not prepared to...
Or, like, your parents.
Oh, God, that would be so awkward. And, like, sometimes I watch things like Terrace House and dramas and stuff with them.
That was even too much for a drama, I think.
Yeah.
I've never seen that from Japanese TV before. I mean, okay, I have seen it on Amoeba and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But not without knowing going into it.
Yeah.
It's not just been thrown at me.
There's always some notification going into it that, okay, you're gonna see people having sex.
Yeah, that's what the, like, age ratings are for.
Yeah.
And they completely forgave that.
That was more shocking than I thought it was gonna be.
I mean, I found it really interesting, but I just wasn't prepared.
Mm.
Well, I guess we can't let 13-year-olds watch this anymore.
Nope.
Nope.
I'm really not sure how to process that.
Like, if she was just naked, that's okay. I feel.
Yeah.
But it was the scene being shown.
I think the scene was too long.
And too graphic.
Yeah.
He was sucking on her boob.
Yeah.
You know, I think the, like, nudity part is fine. I've got nothing wrong with that.
You know what? That is the most you've ever seen of a Terrace House member.
That is true. No, we've seen butts. Remember Daiki butt?
Yeah, but you didn't just see his butt. Just saying.
Well, he did have underwear on.
Did he?
Yeah, he did have underwear on. But you saw, like, the outline of the ball.
Oh, yeah.
The ball. Like, he's only got one. I don't watch Terrace House. Please be my boyfriend.
Yep, please be the episode.
Oh, this would be amazing if it is. No, they're just talking. Ugh. Ugh.
He's getting very tech-chan.
Yeah. At least being a firefighter is a bit more easier, I guess.
The thing is, at least tech-chan tried for things.
Yeah.
He took tests. He went to classes. He studied.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel like Ruka's doing that much.
Hmm.
She literally tapped him in. He's got to start waiting for people to offer him things.
No, the problem isn't just that. There's just like some sort of like vibe.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
It's like a vibe that switches from immaturity to maturity. It's really hard to explain. Hmm. Yeah.
I feel so bad for him at this moment, though.
Hmm.
Like, as much as I agree with what Kenny and Risako are saying.
Hmm.
He's basically just being told everything he was afraid of is true.
Hmm.
Is that he wants to be serious, he wants to be an actor, and he wants to be mature, and he wants Kaori to love him.
Hmm.
He's just being told that Kaori doesn't like him because he's too immature.
Yeah.
And if he doesn't work towards something, he's never going to be an actor.
I don't think it's just like working towards something either. Because Shohei's not working towards anything. Not anything large besides being in porn. And Kaori even said it's not that. It's the way he acts.
Yeah.
And we know people like that as well.
Yeah.
Who act immaturely. And they wonder why they're treated immaturely by other people.
Yeah.
But they have, like, full-time jobs and are productive members of society.
Mm, it's just the way you act.
Yeah.
That's pretty sure.
I think it comes with look at Mr. Porn Star over here.
But that the delivery of that line, it appears there's construction happening.
Yeah.
Oh
my god!
Yes, I am happy. I am so happy. I get to see him again. He is fantastic.
Oh wow! Look at that.
Yes.
Look at those cameras.
Oh. He is literally the best person.
He is.
He's totally being fed lines, but I still love him.
He's the one who, like, brings people up.
Yeah.
He did it with Tech-chan, he did it with Armin.
This guy is the best. Even though he's mostly scripted, he's fantastic.
He's just friends with the producer or something. Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that.
I mean, mean, even once you're married.
Yeah.
As long as you try different things. Don't just say, I like this, but I don't think I'm ready to try it yet.
Yeah. Make sure you're doing something.
Yeah. Do we have a nickname for him yet?
He's Kojima.
Yeah, but he needs a nickname. Because
Koji-san.
Koji-san.
He's the child grandfather.
Koji-san.
Yeah.
I get like the same vibes from him as the guy, you know, in Midnight Diner?
Yeah.
The main guy in Midnight Diner. I get some of the same vibes, except he's more of like a cool Hawaiian style version of him.
A cool Hawaiian style. Yeah. He's not a chef, basically.
Yeah. He's a gardener, which is
perfect.
Yeah. Carbonara.
Yeah.
Oh, what the fuck? Go for it, Kaori.
Scissors would be easier, huh? Yeah, that's not really how you make pasta.
Not really, but Haruka's being a real ass about it.
Yeah. I mean, you put egg in carbonara.
Yeah.
It's not particularly carbonara-y. That's why you make the sauce in the pan, yeah. Not boiled water.
But the other thing is, like, it is, he doesn't cook, and he's trying.
Yeah.
Don't be like, oh, it's like baby's first cooking.
Yeah, no, the way she was acting was not fair. Okay. Everyone has to start somewhere.
But that's got to be, like, such a confidence destroyer for him. He's sitting there trying, and the first time he actually tries.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh, wow, he's such a baby. You know, why did he do that?
Yeah, it was a shocking scene. Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We should give him credit, though. He has cooked more than the chef.
Oh, no, the chef cooked that one time.
One time.
Yeah.
But we never saw him experiment.
No.
We never saw Yuda experiment. Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
I think Kaori was looking for something a bit more positive after dealing with so much negativity.
Yeah. He just doesn't have it.
And he gave the worst response.
Yeah.
Nah, you'll be fine.
I'm loving how like the glass window of Kenny is shattering.
And slowly, you see cracks start forming.
Yeah, it's not like a boom.
It's
and it's working. I think people are finally seeing him for who he is. Yeah. Remember how he said he was very closed to start off with?
Yeah.
It's not that he's closed, it's that he's got nothing there.
Mm,
you open up the door and it's this black, empty room of nothing.
He's hollow.
There's nothing more.
I mean, if he cooked that much.
But yeah, yummy. The reason I learned to cook was by watching other people cook.
Yeah.
And then kind of like working out what tasted good and how that worked.
Mm.
But if he's had no one to do that, then he's going to be like, what do I do here?
He's like, I've seen this eggs in carbonara, right? I know there's eggs in it. Okay, so I'll start with what I know. I'll put in pasta. There's pasta in carbonara. Yeah. And there's eggs in carbonara.
Yeah.
I think I've seen some green stuff. It might be broccoli.
It might be. It might be spinach. Who knows?
Mm.
Oh. That's nice. What was that? Did you see that?
What?
The hair flip.
Who?
Haruka's. She just did like that whole kind of like flirty hair flip thing that she does.
I think what's happening is she might be talking down to Haruka because people are kind of piling on. She might be talking down to Ruka.
Yeah.
Because people are piling onto Ruka about his bad points.
Yeah.
So she's trying to make him look a lot worse than she is.
Maybe. I also think he's really drunk. He looks really drunk, or out of it at least.
Maybe out of it.
Like, it doesn't feel like he's all there.
Mm.
But you can see with his face as well, it's all red as well. So, yeah, it just seems like he's drunk a little bit.
I think most of them were.
Yeah.
Like, for some reason, this episode, everyone really seemed out of it.
Either they were, like, exhausted or drunk or hungover.
Yeah, the only one who seemed to be completely in, not in their element, but aware of what was happening and trying to deal with what was happening was Shohei.
Yeah, and even then, he was playing drunk. That was a weird episode.
I don't know how I feel about that episode. That was...
I mean, it was enjoyable.
It was enjoyable, but I'm really conflicted about a lot of their...
choices this episode.
Yeah.
Like, not just, like... not even just, like, the castmates' choices, but, like, the producers' choices. I love how the Pound did not talk about the porn at all. They just completely sidestepped it.
I don't know. I would have loved to see Tokui.
Tokui is probably like, oh, I've been in this situation before.
like a Tokui step-by-step of the scene.
The commentary probably talks about it.
Yeah.
But I don't know, like, Kaori seems really depressed.
I think she is, because she was starting to doubt herself.
Yeah.
Because of the t-shirt thing.
Yeah, and then the teacher piled onto that.
And then she asked, she basically reached out and was like, you know, I need some help. And everyone's like, oh, you'll do fine.
Well, the teacher was like, no, you're not good enough.
Yeah, the teacher basically, like, I think by how she described it is they were talking kind of candidly.
Yeah.
And then she asked for his honest opinion. Mm. And he just gave all his honest opinion, saying her art style is elementary. That's the English subtitling, so I'm not sure if that's...
Basically, yeah. Probably. Which I... There is honest, and there's being an a-hole.
Mm. Only give criticism if it's constructive in somehow.
Yeah, saying it's too basic isn't good enough, because... Yeah, okay. Looking at Kaori's art, what's the right word?
It's built for product.
It's not detailed. It's not big and extravagant.
Mm.
But that's the point of it.
It is built for illustration for magazines and products and stuff like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, which looks really good.
Yeah.
You know, it's built for what it needs to be done for. But apparently that's not good enough. I find, like, professors a lot of the time, they've got their own style.
Yeah.
And they try and teach their style onto their students. And what ends up happening is that there is a student that they really, really like because that student emulates their style perfectly.
Yeah.
And then every other student who doesn't emulate it or tries to break out of that style, they don't like as much.
Yeah.
And if someone is so deviating from the spectrum, like, for example, when I was in film school, I was doing, like, I was making YouTube videos at the same time, and I was learning After Effects, and I was doing that all my own personal time. So when I went to film school, they were still teaching the basics. I understood that, that's whatever. But I tried to use stuff I had learned previously to try and deviate from the style that the professor wanted to make stuff more interesting, because he wanted really long, boring documentary shots. I'm like, no, we can pace up a little bit, put to some music, do this sort of stuff. And he's just like, this is terrible, this is horrible. But you know what? The other students around me loved watching that sort of thing, right? The long, boring, establishing shots, which sometimes work if you've got a good voiceover. I'm not David Attenborough. I can't deal with that. You know, I'm more of a fast talk, fast da-da-da-da-da thing. It works.
Yeah.
You know? And maybe that's the same thing here. This professor has this sort of style that they really... you know, embody, and that they try and teach with their students, but that style doesn't work for everyone.
When that happens, you just get really depressed.
Exactly. It's
like my high school art teacher, for example, there were three of us that wanted to complete the class at a senior level. And there was me and two of my friends.
Hmm.
One of my friends loved street art, so she paid for her own spray painting classes and did all this outside of class.
Yeah.
So the art teacher hated her.
Yeah, because it wasn't her style.
Her style was very, you know, European, realistic art.
Yeah.
So, you know, street art wasn't her style. And I wanted to do animation, so it wasn't...
It was like anime.
It wasn't perfect anatomy.
Yeah.
And so she hated my style. And there was one other person in the class who did realism.
Yeah.
So she was her ace student, her perfect student.
Yeah, which... it's the point of a teacher is to build up your student's style. And like make them know the basics so they can make their own style and make their own thoughts. Whereas a lot of teachers don't do that. They're like, this is what you have to do, this is it, you know. The point of art is not to stick in the lines. The point of art is to colour in outside of it and to create something beautiful. But when you've got someone that you admire, like a teacher, and especially in Japan where they really, really emphasize the whole teacher-student, the whole senpai-kohai mentality. Yeah. If your teacher said you're doing bad, you listen.
Now, that's a real hit, though.
That, like, and especially someone that seems as traditional as Kaori.
Yeah.
Because Kaori said that she was in this corporate job that she was doing for 3 years and all this other stuff. And it makes sense that she's got that senpai-kohai mentality that her teacher is the one above all.
Yeah.
And then hearing that is terrible. And I think Kaori's art looks great.
Mm.
I'm a real big fan. I'll put something like that up on my wall because that's something I like.
Yeah.
You know, I don't like Kenny's art as much.
Yeah, I think Kenny's art is very...
It seems very American, like SoCal American. Yep.
There's a word that I'm trying to get out, but I don't want to use that word because it's very negative.
What word is it?
It's a very copy-paste style.
Maybe. But it seems like something I'll find, like, some styles at B-side label.
Yeah.
Right, which is, it's not a bad thing. B-side label does some really good designs, but some of the other ones are a bit... Yeah. But that's like that with anything. Like, his art looks good, but it's not my style.
Yeah.
But if I was a teacher, I would look at Kenny's style and be like, that's horrible. You shouldn't draw like that. Draw more like Kaori, which is the wrong thing to say.
Anyway, that was kind of a shocking episode for
many reasons. Yeah,
there were a lot of reasons, which just a lot of pent-up emotion for, like, Ruka dealing with his situation.
Mm-hmm.
Kenny being an impenetrable glass wall that's slowly cracking.
Yeah, the dark void inside.
Shohei suddenly throwing himself into pink films. And Kaori getting depressed because of, you know, her art.
I was really happy they didn't focus on Haruka and Risako's relationship.
Although when Haruka showed up, she ended up being an absolute tool.
I still find that hair flip at the end to be very interesting. Because she's done that before.
Yeah.
But that's when she was flirting. She has the whole hair flip and, like, smile and, like...
Well, that's because she wants to look perfect. She wants to look the best.
Yeah.
And I think that hair flip wasn't towards Ruka. It was towards the camera.
Camera, yeah. I've seen that. I know some people who flirt with the camera.
Yeah.
A lot. Mm. And you can clearly tell they are. Especially when... You're filming them.
Yeah.
And then they go from, like, normal flirty, and I'm just like, no, you're not flirting with the camera here.
Please stop. It's not going to kiss you back.
You cannot make babies with the camera. I don't know, like, how do you feel about the people in the house at the moment?
I think a lot of, like, the people listening will have a completely different viewpoint to the viewpoint we have.
Maybe.
And I'm really interested to see what people took away from this episode, whether it was positive, negative, or otherwise.
I think we're finally coming into Shohei.
Yes.
And that makes me really happy, because before we weren't as happy with him.
Mm.
But now he's kind of coming into his own.
Yeah.
And that's making us really, like, excited to see
him. He was caring for everyone in this episode.
Yeah. He seems like a real good guy.
Yeah.
And I'm really happy. As we see more of him, we seem to like more of him.
Mm.
Ever since the whole... I like Kaori thing with Ruka.
Yeah.
Shohei's become this really cool guy.
Yeah.
Whereas everyone else is kind of... I mean, Ruka got downgraded this episode.
Yeah.
Because he kept saying Marvel.
He kept saying what he wanted to be without ever giving any hint of how he's going to do it.
Yeah, he doesn't give the thought behind it. He's like, I want to do this. How are you going to do that? I want to do this. How are you going to do that? I want to do this.
He's just on repeat button.
And then you got Kenny, who's nothing. Whatever.
Actually, you know who was the star of this episode?
Who?
Koji-san.
Koji-san. Ah, he's looking old.
Yeah, but he's still so cool.
They bring him in to, like, perk up the younger person. Maybe he's going to get a part-time job with him.
Maybe.
Like, I have to wonder if... Like, Terrace House has a contract with this, like, this little tiny garden shop in Kamakura.
I reckon he's got to be friends with someone who, like, owns Terrace House or something like that.
Yeah. Or at least, like, the producer of East Entertainment.
Yeah.
Because there's no way that it's just, like, one little, like, gardening contract that turned into this.
This is not a coincidence. He did not randomly just start gardening at their house.
I mean, they could have. That could have how it turned out, but it's not that. Japan is too nepotistic
yeah.
to do that. They have to be friends somewhere.
Give us more Koji-san.
Yeah, make him a house member. We've been saying that since the beginning.
Yes.
Make him the house
member. I don't care how old he is. Give us Koji-san.
He seems to not mind the 20-year-old girls.
Yeah.
And some of the girls need more experience. Or be slapped around.
Hey.
Haruka.
Oh, God. Leave already.
No, actually, in saying that, this episode finally felt like someone needs to leave.
Yeah.
I think we've finally gotten to the point where there needs to be someone else brought in.
I just hope it's not Shohei.
No, Shohei should stay. Ruka should stay. I don't think Ruka should leave.
I think, yeah, Ruka needs some more push, but I have the feeling he might leave.
No, I think he needs to grow.
At this point, I'm getting the feeling that Kaori or Ruka are going to leave.
No. Nah. I think Kenny's going to leave on the pure fact that everyone, including the panel, thinks he's just there for self-advertisement and not doing anything.
Yeah.
So he's going to be pushed by the producers to do one of two things. Leave or just do something. Because if he doesn't do either of those things,
yeah,
then people are going to get pissed off with him. If the producers don't do it, his manager will say, you have to do something.
Yeah.
I don't mind Haruka leaving.
But I think she would be the last to leave. She's enjoying the spotlight too much.
Yeah. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let us know down in the comments below or on Twitter.
Yeah.
At Terrace House EC.
At Terrace House EC, because I always remember that. I never, ever forget it.
No. And you can also find me on Twitter at Dr. Dazza.
And you can find me on Twitter at The Anites.
And please like the video if you're on YouTube. If you're listening through any of the podcast platforms, you can give ratings.
Yeah.
Just do it, I think, maybe. Yeah.
Rate us what you think.
I feel weird being like, rate us. Rate us 5 stars. Oh, God, that's YouTube from a thousand years ago. And yeah. So this is Terrace House English Couch. We're part of the Yatta-Tachi podcast network.
Yeah.
Where can they find more Yatta-Tachi stuff?
On yatta-tachi.com?
Yes, that is perfect. Good job. Yay.
I told you I remember everything.
You remember everything.
I have a perfect memory. Nothing ever escapes me.
No. And yeah, until next week. Mata ne.
Mata ne.